technology, a good thing normally, right? I mean, advances in technology gave us some pretty neat things over the course of history. From antibiotics to long-distance communication to airplanes to computers. So people should be pretty happy that new technology breakthroughs will make our lives even better in the future. Starship, for example, allowing us to settle on the Moon or Mars.
Or Hyperloop enabling super-fast land travel. Or Neuralink curing many neurological disorders and potentially helping us to avoid an AI extinction event, just to name a few. So people should be really happy about such advances, right? Oh, okay. So let's analyze what the reasons could be for people to hate new technologies.
In 1779, Ned Lott, a weaver from Anstey near Leicester in England, was getting angry and is said to have broken two stocking frames in an outburst. A few decades later, a group emerged that was calling themselves Luddites, transforming Ned Lott into a founding figure of their movement, naming him King Lott, and also naming their movement after him. And what was their movement about? Well, the working conditions in the textile factories of that time weren't really good. In fact, they were really bad. The primary motivation of the Luddites was to oppose and fight the use of automated textile machines that was threatening the jobs and livelihoods of skilled workers. Because these machines would enable much less skilled and thus cheaper workers to replace them, which they of course understandably didn't like. So what did they do? Well, they started to break the weaving machines. What started as some random destruction became a larger movement, culminating in a series of rebellions and battles between 1811 and 1817, where the Luddites destroyed lots of textile machinery and even fought the British Army on two occasions. Okay, nice history, but what does this have to do with new technologies? Well, the term Luddite has now become synonymous with the opposition of new technologies. The same way that the Luddites tried to fight the changing times and the emergence of automation, modern-day Luddites dislike new technological development and try to fight them or oppose them. Thus, the term Neo-Luddite emerged for describing this modern-day phenomenon of hate towards new technological development. And as we on this channel deal basically only with new breakthrough technologies, such as Starship, Hyperloop, boring tunnels, Neuralink, or the re-emergence of electric cars, you can be very sure that we also had to deal with many people who absolutely hate these developments.
But okay, in the case of the Luddites in the early 19th century, it is understandable that they were rebelling and that they destroyed the textile machines because they were threatening their very livelihoods. But then why do, for example, quite a few people seem to hate SpaceX or the Starship? Why would anyone hate Elon Musk so much as to make videos all the time about any of his endeavors in order to try to prove that they are all a bunch of lies? Why would anyone try to prove that Starship, the most revolutionary development in spaceflight, is supposedly all false claims? Why would anyone paint electric cars in such a negative light, as if they were extremely dangerous, randomly exploding, and that they would be supposedly worse for the environment than regular cars? Why would anyone hate on a potentially breakthrough transportation concept such as Hyperloop so much as to dedicate a large portion of his life trying to prove that it's all a bunch of lies? Well, before we answer that question, please subscribe to our channel, because as you can see, we don't only talk about Starship, but we also try to explore some other concepts and ideas that have to do with technology. So thank you very much in advance.
In order to understand why the hate or exaggerated skepticism towards new technological development is absolutely real, we must do a bit of evolutionary psychology. We have to understand that humans are a creature of habit. If you look at human evolution, for the longest time in our history, there was almost no change whatsoever over the entirety of a human lifespan. For someone born 12,000 years ago in the Stone Age, the world would be unchanging. He would die in the same world in which he was born, with no change of any kind taking place. The tools he was using would still be exactly the same. The tribe with whom he or she lived would still be in outside appearance and culture the same. The landscape in which he or she would have lived would also be the same. And this was the case for the longest time of human history. The Homo sapiens sapiens exists since about 300,000 years, according to modern archaeological evidence. However, civilization only exists since around 6,000 years ago. This is only 2% of 300,000 years. And modern-day technology only started developing in the last few hundred years. Before that, for example in antiquity or in the Middle Ages, very little to almost nothing would change during the course of a human life. Technological progress back then was extremely slow compared to now. And if we take into account the whole history of human primates before Homo sapiens sapiens arose, we have millions of years of hominid evolution hardwired into our brains. Therefore, our brains are evolved such as to be very much adapted to slow changes, but very badly adapted to fast changes. However, as now we live in a world of accelerating technological development, changes are happening faster and faster, and changes are occurring in more and more aggressive ways. This is what we call disruption. A new technology does not replace an old one in a very friendly or a continuous way. No, the old technology is often being disrupted by a new one. It's being brutally replaced by the new and superior technology. People working in an industry sector that either produces or lives on the old technology will see their jobs and livelihoods at stake due to the emergence of a new technology.
We can see this, for example, with electric cars. Electric cars have already started replacing gasoline cars, and this will only accelerate even more in the coming years. So all people with jobs connected to gasoline cars will either have to adapt or they will be left behind. It is quite logical then that some people just hate electric cars. We can see that, for example, in the phenomenon of icing Tesla supercharger stations, where gasoline car owners deliberately occupy superchargers just to harass Tesla owners. Or we can see people scratching Teslas with a key, or worse. In this case, the Tesla is being channeled as the object of hate, but the hate is really towards change and the fear that they are being left behind. And of course a dislike for changing their own old ways and their habits, which, as we saw, the human brain is really not well adapted for due to millions of years of evolution. But we can also see this in how the media is portraying visionaries such as Elon Musk. This guy basically wants to change the world in a quite profound way. It is thus clear that technophobes will really hate him. We can see headlines portraying him as a totally crazy and ruthless billionaire who would not hesitate to sacrifice people's lives for his insane endeavors. This can also be seen with all these YouTube channels that cater exactly to such a neo-Luddite audience. Elon Musk's companies or products of his companies or his inventions are thus of course a very popular target of such channels. And since these channels attract technophobe people, quite often of a highly aggressive character, as we ourselves had to find out, they will cheer every time a new video is being made on why this or that invention of Elon Musk certainly won't work and why it is doomed to fail.
But of course, this modern-day phenomenon of hate towards new technologies cannot only be explained by evolution. There is another component at work here, a worldview. Do you have a positive or a negative worldview? Do you think that we live in an amazing and fascinating time or in a really bad time? This is a highly subjective experience and varies wildly from person to person, based on the circumstances under which a person grew up. And if the person had more positive experiences in his or her life, or more negative ones, and how these experiences affected the person, of course. It can thus be said that people that welcome technological breakthroughs and technological changes have a more positive worldview and generally think that we live in an amazing time. We think that never before in the history of humanity Has there been a better time to live than now? Human lifespan is continually rising, medical treatments are improving, and as we now saw, vaccines are being developed at ever faster speeds. Diseases thus overcome. You can talk to anyone on the planet with almost no delay. You can travel in airplanes to anywhere in the world, and much more. All these things we now take for granted were once new breakthrough technologies.
Many people, for example, hate Hyperloop because they say high-speed rail should be totally enough. Why do we need this Hyperloop if we have high-speed rail? But funny that these people forget that trains were once quite hated upon in the mid-19th century, deemed to be dangerous by many, and people back then were saying, why do we need those stupid trains? We have horses. Or the gasoline automobile, which we take for granted, was once a disruptive technology, also towards horses. Many people opposed this new technology. The industry built around horse transportation was completely disrupted by the automobile. Many people didn't like this, and we are sure that could we travel back in time, we would hear similar arguments as the ones that are being brought forth today against, for example, electric cars. So in the end, the worldview and the adaptability of a person to change will determine if that person hates new technologies or if this person embraces them. Of course, we should have a healthy dose of skepticism and not just blindly embrace all new technologies without carefully analyzing the dangers which they might bring. But if a healthy dose of skepticism turns into outrage and hate, then it is quite likely that the previously mentioned psychological mechanisms are at work. A person with a positive worldview, mentally balanced, with a high degree of empathy, and that has a high degree of adaptability, will be very, very unlikely to scratch your Tesla with a key. Whereas a person with a negative worldview, quite possibly in combination with a low degree of empathy and a low degree of adaptability, will be much more likely to do so. Such a person in general will have a very low threshold of attacking proponents of new technologies. But luckily, from our own experience with this channel, we can say that those people are the minority. And even they, with all their ranting and their hating, will not be able to stop technological breakthroughs. They must learn to adapt, or they will be left behind. As always, we'd like to thank the people that helped the channel in some way or another. These are Zabol Chiare, Michael Root, Jay Keegan, Stefan van der Feest,
Another Space Nut, Framrick, Miko, Rich LB,
The Boy Who Stares, MLLT, Warhawk,
Lucky Green and Centauri Sparrow.
You guys are great. Thank you very much for helping us with the channel.
And if you want to join the team, be sure to check out the invite link to our Discord server in the description below. So thanks for watching the JS Disruption Report. And I would say, to the future.